Janet, Life Science Biotech by Abhijit. Now, in last my some previous session, you learn about multiple basic instrumentations and their principles. Now we are going to focus on the element of multiple MS is nothing but the matrix, and what is the uses of it, and what its help in it during the process of multiple MS. Okay, so we today looking on matrix. Matrix is a chemical compound which help in ionization. Okay, but during the mold of MS, we are using a matrix which is depends on what kind of molecule we are going to analyze. Like if you want to analyze some proteins molecules, you use acidic matrix. If you want to analyze oligonucleotides, nucleic acids, then you can utilize the basic matrices. Also, the depends on the chemical nature and the susceptibility of your analyte molecules, the acidic or the basic, depends on that you can be selective or matrix. But in a general routine microbiological analysis and microbiological identification of the microbes, where you can be used acidic matrix like the SCCA. Let's talk about more in during the lecture. Okay, so matrix तो एक तो हमें use करते हैं जब हमें multiplication करना होता है, जब हम plate पे हमारा microorganisms को हम spot करते हैं और उसके ऊपर matrix डालते हैं, तो उस matrix पहले जान लेते हैं matrix बनाते कैसे हैं. ठीक है, एक matrix एक yellow color की powder होती है. Okay, I am talking about the HCCA molecules. HCCA matrix, which is we are using in a microbial identification. Okay, the yellow color ki powder hoti hai, wo hame leni padti hai around 11 to 15 mg per ml. Okay, then hum isme add karte hai 500 microliter of acetonitrile ACN and 475 microliter of pure deionized PCR dead water. Okay, then we add 25 microliter of trifluoroacetic acid. Okay, so now we see why use these chemicals for the or the solvent for the preparation of the matrix. First, we see the trifluoroacetic acid. While we are adding a matrix onto the smear of bacteria or the microorganisms, then that time the cell wall of the organisms get lysed by this trifluoroacetic acid. So whatever the inner content, that means our biomolecules or target molecules, the proteins are comes out, and these proteins are some proteins are hydrophilic in nature, or some are the hydrophobic in nature. So those are the hydrophilic in nature, they dissolve into the water, and whatever the hydrophobic molecules or the proteins, they are dissolved in the acetonitrile. That's why these chemicals are used while preparing the SCCA molecules or the matrix. And now the function of the matrix molecule itself. So as I told you, it's a proton donor. This proton donor is a key component for the ionization. Okay, once he loaded the protons, the protein get excited because of the accepting it. So these proteins are get accelerated by the matrix molecule itself. But you have to know that the matrix are the low molecular weight compound. This is around 200 to 300 molecular weight of these matrices are present level. So, we need to think on that because of this low molecular weight, they are not get evaporated because they are presence in a liquid form. But also you have to be look on that these matrix molecules are not to be get evaporated or the get burned due to the laser intensity, because while you choosing the matrix it should be a low molecular weight, okay, and also having the compatibility with the your biomolecules like the proteins. You have to be take this point also, compatibility. And next point is that you have to be select the matrix which having absorption at UV and IR range. Why this is required? Because while laser irradiations, these matrix molecules should be absorb this heat energy, absorb this radiated energy. Then that possible they are release the protons. Otherwise, if the matrix are get only absorbing or not able to absorb, the molecule burn itself. So इसलिए हमें जो molecules हमारा matrix molecule जो हम choose करते हैं वो उसमें capability होती है कि वो UV और IR radiation को वो absorb कर सकें. ठीक है? तो मैं आपको पहले समझाना चाहता हूँ कि acidic और basic matrix की जो chemical basic chemical structure है वो ऐसे होता है. ये है एसिडिक मैट्रिक्स और ये है बेसिक मैट्रिक्स. तो आपने देखा होगा कि ये दोनों भी में दोनों एसिडिक और बेसिक मैट्रिक्स में एक कॉमन सी चीज है, वो है इसकी एरोमेटिक रिंग. तो दिस एरोमेटिक रिंग प्ले एन इंपॉर्टेंट रोल व्हाइल रेडिएशन लेजर रेडिएशन. दिस एरोमेटिक रिंग एब्सॉर्ब द लेजर एनर्जी एंड the protons or accepting the electrons. Okay, so what is the acidic matrix and basic matrix? So this is the acidic matrix and these are the basic matrices, and we are going to see which matrices use for the which kind of analysis. जैसे कि अगर हमें proteins को analyze करना है तो कौन से matrix use करना चाहिए, हमें lipid का analysis करना है तो कौन से matrix use करना चाहिए, तो हम देखते हैं. ये है acidic matrix. एसिडिक मैट्रिक्स में हम जनरली ये यूज किया जाने वाला मॉलिक्यूल है HCCA मॉलिक्यूल. इसका फुल फॉर्म है अल्फा साइनो 4 हाइड्रोक्सी सिनेमिक एसिड. दिस इज मेनली यूज फॉर द क्लिनिकल लेबोरेटरीज वेयर वी नीड टू आइडेंटिफाई द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स व्हिच इज डिपेंड ऑन देयर प्रोटीन प्रोफाइलिंग, बिकॉज दिस मैट्रिक्स इज यूज फॉर द एनालिसिस एंड डिटेक्शन ऑफ द प्रोटीन्स. ऑल्सो वी कैन बी पेप्टाइड्स वी कैन बी डिटेक्टेड बाय दिस HCCA मॉलिक्यूल्स. Or the HCCA matrix. The another matrix you can be used is a DBH matrix. The full form is the 2-hydroxy benzoic acid. This matrix is very useful for the analysis of the oligonucleotides, peptides, oligosaccharides also. Okay, and third one is the 3-hydroxy picolinic acid. It's called the HPA molecules. Which HPA molecules help in the analysis of the oligonucleotides? This is about the acidic matrix, because these are chemically acidic in nature and they are absorbing the energy and release the protons. The same here, they are the releasing the protons, but they are the basic in nature, that the matrix. Which are these? Which are a 9-aminoacridine. This is the 9-aminoacridine is useful for the low molecular weight proteins, sorry, lipids. And second one is the 1,5-methionine diamine, which is used for the lipid, but the lipid here with the low molecular weight, you can be analysis by the 9th paper, the complexness of the lipids, and whenever you want to amplify imaging there, getting the spectra in a very brief, then you can be used this kind of the matrix. The another basic matrix is the trihydroxyacetophenone. This matrix is used for the oligonucleotides, phosphorylated peptides. So ये जो मैट्रिक्स ऐसे यूज किए जाते हैं हमें हमारे बायोकेमिकल्स को हमारे बायोलॉजिकल इंपोर्टेंट्स एनाटॉमिक मॉलिक्यूल्स प्रोटीन लिपिड्स न्यूक्लिक एसिड्स एक्सेट्रा. सो दोनों में बेसिक डिफरेंस यही है, एसिडिक मैट्रिक्स जो कि एसिडिक नेचर होता है और वो हेल्प करता है आयनाइजेशन में, और यहाँ पे जो होता है वो नेथिलीन लाइक कंपाउंड्स होते हैं जो कि यूजफुल होते हैं आयनाइजेशन. So this all about the matrices. I hope you get. If you have any doubt, any query, you can be write email to me or WhatsApp me.